In this video, let us see how to do the revision because many of the students don't know how to revise. Now, what is the meaning of revise? It is revisiting that topic. Let us see how to revise. Before revision, you must have finished your preparation. I hope you have seen in the previous video how to prepare for the exam. Preparation is different and revision is different. Now, when you are preparing, you have to read the topic thoroughly from the textbook or from your notes. Improvise in your answers. Try to make your own answers. Try to select the diagrams which you are going to draw for your exam. So, before starting your revision, this part should be complete. There are certain things which you should not do. Unlearn them. First thing is, do not revise before preparing. That is not revision, that is your preparation. When you are going to read the topic from your textbooks. Second thing is, do not read everything from the textbook when you are revising, because that is not revision, it is preparation. When you are revising, you should not read everything from the textbook again. And third thing is, do not have a negative attitude in your mind. Do not start your revision with the anxiety that I am going to forget or I will not remember. So, don't start with a negative attitude. So, how to start? First thing you do is you decide your time schedule. So, what am I going to do? Maybe for the week or even for a single day. So, you decide which topic. So, what I am going to do for maybe the topic is too lengthy. So, how much of it you can split it and how long? Remember, do not do a single subject the whole day long. So, if you decide today you are going to revise, you divide it into three subjects. For this much time, I will do anatomy, this much physiology, and this much biochemistry. Doing single subject the whole day, the output will be less. Now, for that particular topic, suppose you are doing upper limb, sit with the FAQs. What are the frequently asked questions or the list of questions that are asked on that topic? If you don't have the list, don't make it now. Now is not the time to waste in making or enlisting the FAQs. Simply sit with your textbook. Open the index and see for the topics and start revision. After you finish, suppose you have made the day's schedule, after you finish, review it. See whether whatever you had decided, you have achieved, or something is pending and you need to include it in your next day's schedule. Now, today we will see two methods of revision. First one is the closed book method. Now, suppose you have prepared thoroughly and you are sure that you will be able to do the revision with the closed book method, you can follow this, or you can start with the open book method. So, by this time, you must have finished your preparation. So, let us start with the closed book method. First, what you do is see which question or which topic you are going to revise. Now, in the closed book method, you have to think of that topic, suppose shoulder joint. Close your eyes and say your answer in your mind or say it aloud, or you start writing just the subheadings of the topic, under which points you are going to write that. Now, I'll tell you an incident. My elder daughter used to study aloud. Means she could not say everything in her mind. So she used to make my younger one, who was quite young when she was doing engineering, she was in 6th or 7th standard. So she used to make her sit in front of her and she used to tell her everything. And she, what was her role, the younger one? Just to say, huh, yes, okay, okay. So she had that habit to say it aloud. So you decide what is best for you and you do it accordingly. Now writing, don't write the whole answer by writing the subheadings. Like for shoulder joint, first you will write type and classification. Second will be the articulating bones, describing the articulating surfaces. You write those words. This will help to increase your writing speed and help you to cover your answers. At the same time, suppose when you are writing relations of shoulder joint, you draw the diagram. Don't write the relations, but draw the diagram of the relations and remember from the diagram, through the diagram. So drawing the diagram is must at the time of revision because all the students are very weak in making the diagram, relevant diagrams in the theory exams. So this is the closed book method. You think of a question, say shoulder joint, close your eyes, close the book and say the answer. What am I going to include in my answer? Either in your mind or aloud, or write the subheadings, whichever suits you. So this we have discussed. What is the open book method? Now some people, some students, they are comfortable or they can recollect better when they have the book open in front of. It is just a psychological support for them in their mind that the book is open and I will remember everything. So in this, what you will see, you will do is you decide that topic, upper limb, in that shoulder joint, you open the page where the shoulder joint is written, just go through the subheadings or just turn the page, and then what you do is either you will write down the subheadings or looking at the subheadings in the textbook, you will revise, but you will not read it. You will just say the things on your own, in your own sentences. Wherever you think that you are forgetting, you just take a look. So this will help you to remember better. Here also, drawing the diagram is must. Now you can use combination. So suppose you are not very sure about your preparation, you can start with the open book for the initial revision and then you can shift to the closed book method. So at least by the time of your prelims, you should do this open book revision without reading the textbooks once or twice for you to be confident. So what are the advantages? By this method, you will retain whatever you have studied for a longer time. It will help to increase your speed of writing and definitely it will give you more confidence. So all the best for your revision. Thank you.